Welcome back everyone, it's Onaldo channel here. Today, we are gonna talk about Awair air quality monitor and how to connect to SmartThings. It's not that hard, you'll not gonna miss anything. It is not necessary having the SmartThings Hub to connect your Awair to your SmartThings app. Even if you don't have SmartThings Hub, you can register Awair, so I think it would be nice to try it out. First step, let's get into the Awair developer's webpage. When you connect to the developer.getaware.com, you'll see the console page. On the upper right corner, press sign in and enter your Awair ID, log in here, and just press the request for access button. Then you'll receive an approval mail within 48 hours. In my case, it took about 2 hours. Now push the go to console button and log in here. Now I am in the console page, access token is located on the left. Press this access token. API token is now on your hand, and copy it for later. Second step, let's go to the SmartThings IDE site and log in. You need to install this smart app in the IDE page. Press my smart apps up here. There are two ways to install it. Do it in manual or get one through GitHub. It's way easier to get it automatically. There might be someone who doesn't have GitHub ID, I'll let you know both. First, integration with GitHub method. Click this setting button and then you see here, Wubuang in owner. And there's Bongthings in name, you need to add this. If you haven't, please add a new repository here. You can write it after you press it. Press save button, and then it. Click settings button, you'll see what we added. If I had added it, press update from repo on the left. Touch the Bongthings you just added. Then, you can see two lists over here, and this is two smart apps created by the Buing. Awair smart app is the one we need right now. Check the items related to the upper part of the item. Click publish under to update them. Now, we can see we've got Awair smart app. Let's go through the manual install. Connect to the GitHub site. Type in keyword Buing. Then here comes the Buing's repository. There are device types and smart apps on the list. Click this smart app folder, you'll see the same page as the first way. We want to install the Awair, click one more. The smart app code created by the Buing will be shown. You can press raw here. Control plus A, Control plus C, easy. Let's go back to the SmartThings IDE site. Click plus new smart app button. Paste the from code area over here. And then, create, it's installed. Save the code to the IDE, publish for me. That's it. We can see the smart app installed. The difference between two is that if the Buing updated this smart app later, you can update by update from repo button. You can check the items here publish, update them, it's very simple. However, if you install it manually, go back to the Buing's repository. Control the updated code equally, Control plus A, Control plus C. And then you come back to the IDE site. Just tap the list of smart apps. You need to change the code here. We need to update it this way. So I strongly recommend connect the GitHub if you can. Now, let's install DTH as well. Those who connected to GitHub, in update from repo, press Buangthings as it is. You can check the DTH related to the Awair here. There are so many versions of this right now. Support for Awair Mints, 1st and 2nd edition. The device you have, 2nd generation, then you don't have to install anything else. But you might have another Awair someday later, just install them all at once. Publish here, update it. So we can confirm that we have a DTH. DTH installation can be done manually as well. And the way to do it manually is to do it. Go into the Buing's repository. We saw the SmartApp folder earlier. This time, you can see the device type folder. If you look at the device type, it's like this. There is a DTH related to the Awair. So I'm going to choose one DTH code. I'll copy it. On the SmartThings IDE site, press create new device handler to the right. pressing the from code, you can paste it here like this. Quite easy, right? It's very easy. Now, its final step. Install the Awair Smart app on the SmartThings app and insert access token that we've got at the first step to the Smart app. Open the SmartThings Classic app. Click automation button on the tabs below. There will be a button called plus add a Smart app. Scroll down. There's my Smart app button. You can select the Smart app you installed here. You can type in the token that we received from the developer site, paste the code in the box. Save, please. So we've got Awair Smart app installed in automation section. If you click on this Awair Smart app, email information and user information is in the app. Click user information, there's this basic information. This Awair API has a policy called tier. Harvest tier, which is the current policy, we have a call limit of 300 times per day. The time to pull the data in is going to come in every 5 minutes, and if you look at the API call limit count below, you can see that there are 300 restrictions. I'm back on my main account. If you look at thing on my home here, you can see that there are 2 Awair devices on this side. Now, that's how it looks. Temperatures, humidity, carbon dioxide, VOC, PM2.5, it almost fully supports WebCore. Those who are not in South Korea don't want to see the Korean standard. If you want to erase the Korean standard, get in DTH search for details by pressing Ctrl plus F on line 432. There's Korean standards over here. You can delete these lines. You erase it. You erase it. Save and then publish for me. You can see that the Korean standard has disappeared. So today, we just connect the Awair to SmartThings. Please subscribe, alarm, like for me. Thank you for watching us today.